We continue our reading of From the Heart, a daily devotional by author Ellen G. White. Today's reading, May 22. The eye of the Lord is upon you. The eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears are open to their cry. Psalm 34:15. The opinion is widely held that spirituality and devotion to God are detrimental to health. While this conclusion is radically false, it is not without apparent foundation. Many who profess to be Christians are ever walking under a cloud. They seem to think it is a virtue to complain of depression of spirits, great trials, and severe conflicts. But these persons do not correctly represent the religion of the Bible. So far from being antagonistic to health and happiness, the fear of the Lord lies at the foundation of all real prosperity. The consciousness of right doing is the best medicine for diseased bodies and minds. Those who are at peace with God have secured the most important requisite to health. The blessing of the Lord is life to the receiver. The assurance that the eye of the Lord is upon us and his ear open to our prayer is a never-failing source of satisfaction. To know that we have an all-wise friend to whom we can confide all the secrets of the soul is a privilege which words can never express. The gloom and despondency supposed to be caused by obedience to God's moral law is often attributable to disregard of his physical laws. Those whose moral facilities, faculties, are beclouded by disease are not the ones to rightly represent the Christian life. To show forth the joys of salvation or the beauties of holiness, they are too often in the fire of fanaticism or the water of cold indifference or stolid gloom. It is the duty of every Christian to follow closely the example of Christ to cultivate peace and hope and joy, which will be manifested in unfeigned cheerfulness and habitual serenity. Thus, may they shed light upon all around them, instead of casting the dark shadow of discouragement and gloom. Many are constantly craving excitement and diversion. They are restless and dissatisfied when not absorbed in mirth, frivolity, and pleasure-seeking. These persons may make a profession of religion, but they are deceiving their own souls. They do not possess the genuine article. Their life is not hid with Christ in God. They do not find in Jesus their joy and peace. Signs of the Times, June 15, 1882. This concludes our reading today of From the Heart. What a day that will be.
What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see, and I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, when he takes me by the hand and leads me through.
There'll be no sorrow there, no more burdens to bear, no more sickness, no more pain, no more parting over there.